The Rolling Stones are going back on tour this May, and they head to Soldier Field for two shows in June.
And Chicago's very own Rolling Stones bassist Darryl Jones will be there. He's in town this weekend for a benefit concert at the Promontory in Hyde Park. Good to see you again, Darryl. Thanks for getting up early with us.
Thank you very much for having me.
Boy, every time, I feel like we've heard, this is it. Not happening again, but it's like the demand, people just still pack these shows for the Stones.
Yeah, now people seem to be, I have fans coming to me telling me, you know, I've seen 200 shows. The one that I saw last night was the best one.
God.
So something's still happening with these guys.
So yeah. They still got it. I mean, Keith Richards, we wondered if he was going to keep cracking along, and he's doing really well.
He's doing great. He's really doing great. Playing, you know, last tour we did, he played better than ever, I think.
Wow.
See, now, as someone who doesn't really play instruments at all, what do you mean he's playing better than ever? Does that mean, like, what does that mean?
You get to a place, I guess, you know, you're doing this long enough, you get to a place where you're not doing it for money anymore. You're not doing it, you know, for fame. You're doing it because you love doing it. Yeah. And they seem to all be really in that place right now.
So he says he gave up alcohol recently. Mm-hmm. Does that enable him to play sharper or louder? Or what? Does it have an impact?
I think he's playing better. I think he's playing great. You know, I mean, there's a certain rock and roll lifestyle that we've been hearing about for years, but you know, the music can be enough, you know, and I think that, you know, everybody's kind of come to that place where it's about the music and it's not about all that other stuff.
Darryl, for people who don't know your story and are seeing you on our show for the first time, tell them how you started playing with the Stones.
Well, I actually was, I met Keith through Charlie Drayton and Steve Jordan, who were in his band, Expensive Winos. And so I'd, you know, been, you know, palling around with him a little bit, you know, mm-hmm. when those guys were on tour. And I wanted to play in that band.
The Expensive Winos?
I wanted to play in the Expensive Winos, and another friend of ours got that gig. And about a year later, so a friend of mine here called me and said, hey man, I hear Bill Wyman's leaving the band. And I thought, man, Bill Wyman's been leaving the band forever. And he said, no, he's going this time.
Wow.
And he said, do you want me to find some numbers? And he found some numbers. I called around and auditioned a couple of times. And
well, how nervous were you on that audition?
Oh my gosh, right?
You know, it's funny because the really important auditions in my life have been very informal and very cool. And so I didn't feel, Mick said to me, he said, man, you know, if you don't know the tunes, we'll teach you the tunes and then we'll have the audition. So it was very informal. They were very nice.
Oh, that's great.
And so I didn't feel a lot of a nervousness. And
I'm sure it's tough to walk into a group that's been together for so long. You seem to have such a easy way about you. Is that why it's just like you kind of go in and you just let them do their thing and you just do your part?
Yeah, you want to bring yourself to the thing, but you don't want it to be like, you know, the Rolling Stones and this new guy. You want to play the music in a way that makes you feel like this is still the Rolling Stones playing.
Yeah.
You know, with maybe a little extra bump, you know, a little extra Chicago
South
Side bump.
Was there a moment you remember that you felt like, okay, now I'm one of them?
My accountant assures me we haven't gotten to that point yet.
What?
But I will say that we played in Cuba a few years ago, and something happened that night on stage. I was really, really very, very thankful to be there. I mean, I'm thankful to be playing music.
Sure.
You know, I really am. Every time I pick up an instrument, it's a blessing for me.
Tell people why you're in Chicago and who this benefit is for.
Okay, I grew up, again, you know, in a city, you know, full of musicians. And the guys who I learned to play with, a little bit older than me, Brian Messiah was one of them. These guys, playing with them really taught me how to play.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sure it was Brian Messiah who told me, Keith Richards, he's an important figure. Check out what he does. Check out, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So these guys really provided a lot of the material for me to learn what to do in all of these different situations. And Brian had a very unfortunate accident a while back. And we are trying to raise money to help him. He had a serious spinal injury.
Oh, jeez.
We are hoping that with some therapy and some rehabilitation, he may get better. You know?
Well, you can see all the information on our screen. Darryl Jones is tomorrow. Is it 3 p.m. at the Promontory?
3 p.m.
At the benefit concert. Darryl, great to see you again.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for being here. Mm-hmm.